Hi everybody, welcome back. We've come to see Dan today. He's got a day off work, and obviously I've managed to pinch a bit of time. So I rang him yesterday and I said, listen mate, I've got another car to feature. And he said, oh, what is it? I said, well, I'm not going to tell you. And he says, it's not a fucking Honda, is it? I said, well, it might be, but he'll have to wait and see. So he doesn't know what it is. I've just come and given him a knock, so we'll see how he's feeling about it. I don't know how he's going to take this, like. Here she is, mate. What do you think?
It's a Honda.
Mate, don't be like that. What an arsehole. All this scrap and he's driving, he's twisting about a bloody Honda. Mate, it's a 500 horsepower Honda. $500 mate. Are we alright with that?
I am, of course.
Cushy.
Yeah. Well, before we take off, what we're dealing with here?
Right, so welcome everybody. Again, thanks people who are tuning to the channel. We're enjoying all the comments and stuff, so we appreciate it. Today we're back in something that I've been quite excited about for quite a while. The car belongs to a lad called Andrew Nesbitt. And what we've got today, which we'll detail shortly, is a Civic EB3 pre-facelift on a 2002 with no less and rolling roaded, all proven, 489 horsepower. So it's
that's a lot.
It's a lot of power for this.
We must have some canny tyres on, haven't we?
We haven't. No, we've got Poverty Spec 2s, otherwise known as Prada Spec 2s.
Yokohamas.
Yokohamas.
I'm going back again.
Yeah, the tyres are something, the owner, obviously Andrew Nesbitt, he's been speaking to us about changing the tyres, so we are going to 808 ours, and these tyres, to be fair, are absolutely pish. At the minute, I mean, I've spent a lot of time the last couple of days driving this, and it's lighting its wheels up at fourth into fifth gear, so it's an absolute animal. Plate the diff as well, by the way, and it's still lighting them up.
We're not actually playing this down now, that I have never been in this car before, and he's put me straight in the driver's seat.
Yeah, I thought it'd be the best way. Dan's never experienced it, so you'll get like a genuine view from Dan, first time he's driven it, so there's the paddle clutch and the plate of diff. Sounds like it's broke.
I think it is broke, eh?
Wow. So this car is basically, the lad that owns it, he's a good friend of mine, I've known him for a lot of years. We move in similar circles, a good lad by all accounts, and we've had similar cars over the years. Andrew, for his job, is a driving instructor.
Brings setting fine examples all over the northeast of England.
He brings a whole new meaning to the fast pass service. Let's put it that way. But yeah, it's an absolute machine. This thing, it really is leery and it's loud and it's.
Other than the clutch and the diff, it actually just drives like a Civic.
It drives. I mean, the car, when you drive the car off boost, just drives like a normal Honda. I mean, it's got a proper M factory plated diff in, so the diff is quite harsh when you're turning. When you're trying to drive it generally, but it's really well. This car's literally is really well put together. It feels like a
clean as well.
Oh man, it's mint in here. The bodywork, which we'll show you as well, for an 02 reg car, it's been painted, but the car's mint, absolutely mint.
Other than the noise, it genuinely feels like a 200 horsepower. Honestly,
does it? Does.
It's a nice car. Drives tight as anything.
We tried to find somewhere to test the car properly today, but unfortunately Newcastle Airport were quite busy, so we're going to have to make the best with what we've got.
We'll be doing a 0 to 70 run.
Thank you, the 0 to 70s that we've done.
That was a pothole.
Yeah, it was a pothole.
I can tell this isn't your car, you know.
What?
It's saying all the fuel.
Well, mate, can we just touch on the fuel? Obviously Dan, with that point, knows that I'm tight. Quite tight, yeah. I have put £60 worth of OptiMax in this car since 9 o'clock last night. Bearing in mind, 9 o'clock last night, I was home for half past, so I spent half an hour in it yesterday. I've spent half an hour in it this morning, and it's cost me £60 for the pleasure. It's been worth every penny, but yeah, it's expensive to run, without a doubt.
Did you have a tear in your eye, handing £60 out?
I cry out of one eye, maybe. Be ready to be impressed.
Yeah,
mad. That diff's mad. You should be nervous, keep hold of it.
Fucking hell.
just a pull from second gear. Obviously, that's with its wheels lit up, and I've got sweaty palms of you.
Oh, I'll tell you what, mate, I've had some quick fucking cars over the years, like.
Crazy, that, isn't it?
That's nerve wracking.
That's crazy, mate. That's crazy.
Oof.
Oh, I love cars like this, mate, you know, mate. The
what
class.
A
I love it, I love it. How mad's that though? Like, seriously, it's crazy, isn't it?
I'm gonna let you drive. Yeah. I've had enough. Well, we'll pull in.
It's off this one here.
I'm not even sure I like that, you know. That is.
It's crazy, isn't it?
That's berserk.
Been kicked out on a country road. This car's coming, I look a bit of a tit now. Hang fire. Thought we'll give you some outside footage of the car. You probably hear it. And smell is Shell Optimax. It absolutely stinks. Where is he?
And he's back. Guys, you'll have just seen a bit driving in this absolute menace of a thing stood behind us. It's absolutely insane, this car. It's ridiculous. It kind of takes the fun out of driving for me. It's uncontrollable, but it excites me.
It's a scary car, isn't it? It is a scary car, like.
Now, Anthony knows the car very well. He's known it for a long time since Nevi got it. So Anthony's going to give us a quick rundown as to what's done with this.
I'm going to try. There's a lot to remember. So the car's got Wisecore pistons, Manly rods, Supertech valve springs with bronze guides. It's running a GT30 turbo, 470 fuel pump, I believe. Now the car, when Andrew bought it, the fuel problems, it was literally blown holes in the fuel lines. So it's just had all new fuel system put into this with proper EN10 fittings. And to be fair, there's no words can just describe what the car is. You can see what kind of car it is. It's a fully built motor. It was built by a racing company down south. I forget the name of them. But it's a very well put together car. See, it's amazing.
I think we'll probably need to add the name of these people in a little
I don't know the name of the company, but I'll get you. But it's been there.
Well organised.
Mutual friend of ours, been to Jamie up at Evo Tune, and Jamie spent about, well, I think he spent about 6 weeks been through the full car, ironed out any little issues, any heat soak issues. So it's running very well at the minute. As you can see from the video, it's running very, very well.
Just a note there, I've used Jamie from EvoTune quite a bit. I think a lot of people in the Northeast do. Jamie doesn't know we're mentioning this, but he is. If you've got problems with any high performance, any tune motors, give him a shout. He is fantastic at what he does.
He's not the happiest of people, but he's a good guy.
Aye, cheer up, you miserable bastard. He's alright, really.
Aye,
sound
like he's happy.
But yeah, it looks special.
That's one of the things I like about it.
the car, I mean, don't get us wrong, it's got a front mount on and it's got big six-pot K-Sport brakes, but to look at the car without paying a keen eye on it, it's a standard E3, which is what I love about it. Supercar Slayer, basically, there's no other two ways to it. Once you get in the motorway, you get in that 56 gear, there's not much catching this. Like, it's like bike territory, isn't it?
It is, aye.
Motorbike fast.
Only way you can describe it. Any bikers thinking that's not right, I'm a biker myself, trust us, it is that quick.